Hi, I'm Jane McKenzie. I'm going to show you a combination of exercises now, standing combination exercises that are going to work the inside of the thigh, the adductors, the abductors on the outside of the thigh, the glutes, gluteus medius on the bottom, and also the quads on the front of the leg and the gluteus maximus. So pretty much all the way around here while these muscles are holding us in position. So to start with, we're going to take a squat. So I'm going to show you that facing forwards and from the side. So from there, you're going to do it with your hands on your legs initially. Push the bottom out behind you. Imagine you're opening a door with your bottom whilst holding a tray. So from there, sitting down, your knees, have a look down. Make sure you can see your toes as you do this. So your knees remain over your ankles. And from there, slowly coming up, pulling the abdominals in, squeeze through the gluteal muscle as you come up. So I'm going to show you that again. I'm going to turn sideways so you can see it from the side. So push the bottom out behind you. Use the hands on the legs if you want to support the back, pulling the abdominals in. If you want to, you can take the hands in front, sitting down into it, taking it no lower than 90 degrees, and then slowly coming back up again. So that's your first move. So get used to doing that squat. So either hands on the legs here. From there, bring the arms in front if you want to. If that isn't comfortable for you or you need that support for your back, pull the abdominals in and then slowly coming back up. Make sure you can see the feet right the way through that move. So glance down and have a look. Our next move we're going to add on is the side leg. So bring the leg across the body. So standing on one leg, gently bring the foot across the body and then take that foot, if you can, without touching the floor, directly to the side to work the inside and then outside of the thigh, and then slowly lower. So taking that leg across the body and then out to the side. Pulling in through here, keep the shoulders over the hips and release it down. So we're going to combine those three moves together. So take it into our squat position. Make sure that the head is looking down to, not right at the floor, but ahead of you, so that we're not lifting up on the head. From there, pushing the bottom up towards the ceiling, bring that leg across the body, leading with the heel, and take it out to the side, and then squeeze. So you feel that through here, and then release it down. So again, into your squat position, hands on the legs, or take the hands out in front of you, pulling in through the abdominals, squeeze up on the glutes if you want to, zip up on that pelvic floor as well as you lift. And slowly bring the leg across the body and take it out to the side. So the knee and toe face forwards as you take that leg to the side and release it down. Excellent. We've got one more move to add on to that. Now, if you want to, you could just do the squats on their own, get used to doing those. Then we could do the side leg lift on its own, get used to doing those, and gradually build it up. So we're now going to add a diagonal back right corner to work the gluteus medius. That's this muscle right in here. So from here, we want to really activate the core muscles. Well, we do all the way through, but particularly on this move, because we're going to lean forward a diagonal ever so slightly. As you take that leg back, really pull in through here. And from there, we take the leg, it's not straight back, it's to the diagonal corner of the room. So it works in here, and then release it down. The supporting knee is soft as we do this. Take the other leg, diagonal, back corner, and release it down. So let's put that whole thing together. So we take it into a squat, push the bottom out behind you, gently coming down. Remember, keep the speed nice and controlled, breathing out on the way up if you can remember, or just keep breathing. Take that leg diagonally across the body, leading with the heel, pulling in through the abdominals, shoulders back and down. Take that leg out to the side, knee and toe face directly forward, supporting knee is soft. Then take that knee, diagonal back corner, and release it down. Let's do that again on the other leg. So from there into that squat position, make sure you can see your toes, slowly coming up, so keep the knees over the ankles, take that leg across the body, leading with the heel, knee and toe face forwards as we lift that leg to the side, only lift it until you can feel it working here. Then take it diagonal, back corner. Good, squeezing through here. and release it down. Lovely. I'm just going to show you one more sequence through that, but adding arms to it if you wish. Now, again, practice this through without the arms. Use a mirror to check your form, make sure that everything's in line. Only add the arms when you're really confident that you've got the balance and you've got the core stability to hold you in position. So into that squat position, pushing out, push the bottom out behind you, sit down into it, slowly coming up. Bring that leg across the body, and then from there, take one arm diagonally in line. So we've got a line running from the fingers down to the toes, and then the same on that diagonal. So bring the arm slightly in front and release it down. And we do the same on the other leg. Sitting down into it, push the bottom out behind you, slowly coming up. Take that leg across the body, and then take it out and add that arm to a diagonal. And then take it diagonal back corner, so the arm comes slightly in front of you because the leg's going slightly behind you on a diagonal angle. And keep that line, so you've got a line running from your hand right the way down to your toes. And release it down, well done. So you do a combination of whichever ones you find comfortable for you.